This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. 473% White British, 15% White Irish, 01% White Gypsy or Irish Traveller, 63% Other White, 27% White. Mentioned in the Doomsday Book, and from a small market town has expanded into one of the most populous areas on the fringe of London. Croydon is the civic centre of the borough. The borough is now one of London's leading business, financial and cultural centres, and its influence in entertainment and the arts contribute to its status as a major metropolitan centre formed in 1965 from the Coolsden and Purley Urban District and the County Borough of Croydon. The local authority Croydon London Borough Council, is now part of the Local Government Association for Greater London. London Council's the economic strength of Croydon dates back mainly to Croydon Airport, which was a major factor in the development of Croydon as a business centre once London's main airport for all international flights to and from the capital. It was closed on 30 September 1959 due to the lack of expansion space needed for an airport to serve the growing city. It is now a Grade 2 listed building and tourist attraction. Croydon Council and its predecessor Croydon Corporation unsuccessfully applied for city status in 1954, 2000, 2002 and 2012. The area is currently going through a large regeneration project called Croydon Vision 2020, which is predicted to attract more businesses and tourists to the area, as well as backing Croydon's bid to become London's third city after the city and Westminster. Croydon is mostly urban, though there are large suburban and rural uplands in the south. Since 2003, Croydon has been certified as a Fair Trade Borough by the Fair Trade Foundation. It was the first London borough to have Fair Trade status, which is awarded on certain criteria. The area is one of the hearts of culture in London and the southeast of England. Institutions such as the major arts and entertainment centre Fairfield Halls add to the vibrancy of the borough. However, its famous fringe theatre, the Warehouse Theatre, was put under administration in 2012 when the council withdrew its funding and the building itself was demolished in 2013. The Croydon Clock Tower was opened by Queen Elizabeth II in 1994 as an arts venue featuring a library. The independent David Lean Cinema closed by the council in 2011 after 16 years of operating, but now partially reopened on a part-time and volunteers basis. And museum from 2000 to 2010, Croydon staged an annual summer festival celebrating the area's Black and Indian cultural diversity, with audiences reaching over 50,000 people. An internet radio station, Croydon Radio, is run by local people for the area. The borough is also home to its own local TV station, Croydon TV. Premier League football club Crystal Palace FC play at Selhurst Park in South Norwood, a stadium they have been based in since 1924. Other landmarks in the borough include Addington Palace, an 18th-century mansion which became the official second residence of six archbishops, Shirley Windmill, one of the few surviving large windmills in Greater London built in the 1850s, and the Brit School, a creative arts institute run by the Brit Trust which has produced artists such as Adele, Amy Winehouse and Leona Lewis. Contents 1 History 2 Governance 21 Politics of Croydon Council 22 Westminster Representation 23 Civic History 24 Government Buildings 3 Geography and Climate 31 Townscape Description 32 Topography and Climate 33 Architecture 4 Demography 41 Population Change 5 Economy 6 Landmarks 7 Transport 71 National and International Travel 72 Local Travel 73 Travel to Work 8 Public Services 81 Health Services 82 Waste Management 83 London Fire Brigade 84 Education 85 Libraries 9 Religion 10 Sport and Leisure 11 Culture 12 Media 13 Twinning 14 Investment in the Tobacco Industry 15 See also 16 References 17 External links History for the history of the original town. See History of Croydon. The London Borough of Croydon was formed in 1965 from the Coolsden and Purley Urban District and the County Borough of Croydon. The name Croydon comes from Crogdean or Croendun, named by the Saxons in the 8th century when they settled here. Although the area had been inhabited since prehistoric times, it is thought to derive from the Anglo-Saxon Creus Dianus, meaning the Valley of the Crocuses, indicating that, like Saffron Walden in Essex, it was a centre for the collection of saffron by the time of the Norman invasion. Croydon had a church, a mill and around around 365 inhabitants as recorded in the Domesday Book. The Archbishop of Canterbury, Archbishop Lanfranc, lived at Croydon Palace, which still stands. Visitors included Thomas Becket, another archbishop, and royal figures such as Henry VIII of England and Elizabeth I. Croydon carried on through the ages as a prosperous market town. They produced charcoal, tanned leather, and ventured into brewing. Croydon was served by the Surrey Iron Railway, the first public railway horse-drawn in the world, in 1803, and by the London to Brighton Rail Link in the mid-19th century, helping it to become the largest town in what was then Surrey. In the 20th century, Croydon became known for industries such as metal working, car manufacture and its aerodrome, Croydon Airport starting out during World War I as an airfield for protection against Zeppelins, an adjacent airfield was combined, and the new aerodrome opened on 29 March 1920. It became the largest in London, and was the main terminal for international air freight into the capital. It developed into one of the great airports of the world during the 1920s and 1930s, and welcomed the world's pioneer aviators in its heyday. British Airways Limited used the airport for a short period after redirecting from Northolt Aerodrome, and Croydon was the operating base for Imperial Airways. It was partly due to the airport that Croydon suffered heavy bomb damage during World War II as aviation technology progressed, however, and aircraft became larger and more numerous. It was recognized in 1952 that the airport would be too small to cope with the ever-increasing volume of air traffic. The last scheduled flight departed on 30 September 1959. It was superseded as the main airport by both London Heathrow and London Gatwick Airport. See below. The air terminal, now known as Airport House, has been restored, and has a hotel and museum in it. In the late 1950s and through the 1960s, the council commercialised the centre of Croydon with massive development of office blocks and the Whitgift Centre, which was formerly the biggest in-town shopping centre in Europe. The centre was officially opened in October 1970 by the Duchess of Kent. The original Whitgift School there had moved to Hayling Park, South Croydon in the 1930s, the replacement school on the site, Whitgift Middle School, now the Trinity School of John Whitgift, moved to Shirley Park in the 1960s when the buildings were demolished. The Borough Council unsuccessfully applied for city status in 1965, 2000 and again in 2002. If it had been successful, it would have been the third local authority in Greater London to hold that status, along with the City of London and the City of Westminster. At present, the London Borough of Croydon is the second most populous local government district of England without city status, Kirklees being the first. Croydon's applications were refused as it was felt not to have an identity separate from the rest of Greater London. In 1965, it was described as now just part of the London conurbation and almost indistinguishable from many of the other Greater London boroughs, and in 2000 as having no particular identity of its own. Croydon, in common with many other areas, was hit by extensive rioting in August 2011. Reeves, an historic furniture store established in 1867, that gave its name to a junction and tram stop in the town centre, was destroyed by arson. Croydon is currently going through a vigorous regeneration plan, called Croydon Vision 2020. This will change the urban planning of central Croydon completely. Its main aims are to make Croydon London's third city and the hub of retail, business, culture and living in South London and South East England. The plan was showcased in a series of events called Croydon Expo. It was aimed at business and residents in the London Borough of Croydon to demonstrate the £35 billion development projects the council wishes to see in Croydon in the next 10 years. There have also been exhibitions for regional districts of Croydon, including Wadden, South Norwood and Woodside, Purley, New Addington and Coolsden, examples of upcoming architecture. Featured in the expo can easily be found to the centre of the borough in the form of the Croydon Gateway site and the Cherry Orchard Road Towers. Governance. The 24 electoral wards of the London Borough of Croydon, and the surrounding districts. The three constituencies of the London Borough of Croydon, Croydon North, Croydon Central and Croydon South. Politics of Croydon Council. Further information, Croydon local elections. Croydon Council has 70 councillors elected in 24 wards. Croydon is a cabinet-style council, and the leader heads a 10-person cabinet, its members responsible for areas such as education or planning. There is a shadow cabinet drawn from the sole opposition party. A backbench cross-party scrutiny and overview committee is in place to hold the executive cabinet to account. From the borough's creation in 1965 until 1994, the council saw continuous control under first Conservatives and residences ratepayers councillors up to 1986, and then Conservatives from 1994 to 2006. Labour Party councillors controlled the council after a further 8 8-year period of conservative control, the Labour Group secured a 10-seat majority in the local council elections on 22 May 2014. Councillor Tony Newman returned to lead the council for Labour in the 2014 local elections. The Labour Party gained all the seats in the Ashburton and Wadden wards and gained the one seat held by the Conservatives in the New Addington ward. The election marked the first time that Ashburton ward had been represented by Labour. Elected as a Labour councillor in Wadden was Croydon Central's previous Conservative then independent MP and leader of the Conservatives on Croydon Council up to 2005, Andrew Pelling. At the 2010 Croydon local elections, seats lost previously in Addiscombe, South Norwood and Upper Norwood were retaken by Labour Party councillors. In New Addington, the Conservative Party gained a councillor, the first time that the Conservatives had taken a seat there since 1968. The composition of the council after the 2010 elections was Conservatives 37, Labour 33. Mike Fisher, Conservative group leader since May 2005, was named as council leader following the Conservative victory in 2006. Since 2000, at the 2006 local elections, Conservative councillors regained control in gaining 12. The two previous by-elections to 2006, one by a councillor from the incumbent party, in both cases the party of a councillor who had died, crossover has occurred in political affiliation. During 2002-2006, one Conservative councillor defected to Labour, went back to the Conservatives and spent some time as an independent. In March 2008, the Labour councillor Mike Mogul joined the Conservatives, while a Conservative councillor became an independent. Councillor Jonathan Driver, who became mayor in 2008, died unexpectedly at the close of the year, causing a by-election in highly marginal Wadden, which was successfully held by the Conservatives from February 2005 until May 2006. The leader of Croydon Council was Labour Cooperative Councillor Tony Newman, succeeding Hugh Mallion. Westminster representation. The borough is covered by three parliamentary constituencies for the Westminster Parliament. These are Croydon North, Croydon Central and Croydon South. There are 24 wards which represent Croydon Council civic history. For much of its history, Croydon Council was controlled by the Conservative Party or Conservative-leaning independents. Former Croydon councillors include former MPs Andrew Pelling, Vivian Bendall, David Congdon, Garrett Davies and Reg Prentice, London Assembly member Valerie Shawcross, Lord Bonus, John Donaldson, Baron Donaldson of Lymington, Master of the Rolls and H.T. Muggeridge, MP and father of Malcolm Muggeridge. The first mayor of the newly created county borough was Jabez Balfour, later a disgraced Member of Parliament. Former Conservative Director of Campaigning, Gavin Barwell, was a Croydon councillor between 1998 and 2010 and since 2010 as the MP for Croydon Central. Some 10,000 people work directly or indirectly for the council, in its main offices at Bernard Wetherill House or in its schools, care homes, housing offices or work depots. The council is generally well regarded, having made important improvements in education and social services. However, there have been concerns over benefits, leisure services and waste collection. Although the council has one of London's lower rates of council tax, there are claims that it is too high and that resources are wasted. The mayor of Croydon for 2010-11 is Councillor Avril Slipper. The leader is CLLR Mike Fisher and the deputy leaders are CLLR Tim Pollard and CLLR Dudley Mead. The chief executive since 7 July 2007 has been John Rowse. Government buildings: Croydon's Victorian Town Hall, Croydon Town Hall on Catherine Street in central Croydon houses the committee rooms, the mayor's and other councillors' offices, electoral services and the arts and heritage services. The present town hall is Croydon's third. The first town hall is thought to have been built in either 1566 or 1609. The second was built in 1808 to serve the growing town but was demolished after the present town hall was erected in 1895. The 1808 building cost £8,000, which was regarded as an enormous sum for those days and was perhaps as controversial as the administrative building Bernard Wetherill House. House opened for occupation in 2013 and reputed to have cost £220 million. The early 19th century building was known initially as Courthouse, as, like its predecessor and successor, the local court met there. The building stood on the western side of the High Street near to the junction with Surrey Street, the location of the town's market. The building became inadequate for the growing local administrative responsibilities and stood at a narrow point of a high street in need of widening. The present town hall was designed by local architect Charles Henman and was officially opened by the Prince and Princess of Wales on 19 May 1896. It was constructed in red brick, sourced from Rotham in Kent, with Portland stone dressings and green Westmoreland slates for the roof. It also housed the court and most central council employees. The borough's incorporation in 1883 and a desire to improve central Croydon with improvements to traffic flows and the removal of social deprivation in Middle Row prompted the move to a new configuration of town hall provision. The second closure of the Central Railway Station provided the corporation with the opportunity to buy the station land from the London, Brighton and South Coast Railway Company for £11,500 to provide the site for the new town hall. Indeed, the council hoped to be able to sell on some of the land purchased with enough for municipal needs and still leave a considerable margin of land which might be disposed of. The purchase of the failed railway station came despite local leaders having successfully urged the reopening of the poorly patronized railway station. The railway station reopening had failed to be a success, so freeing up the land for alternative use. Parts, including the former courtrooms, have been converted into the Museum of Croydon and exhibition galleries. The original public library was converted into the David Lean Cinema, part of the Croydon Clock Tower. The Braithwaite Hall is used for events and performances. The town hall was renovated in the mid-1990s. And the imposing central staircase, long closed to the public and kept for councillors only, was reopened in 1994. The civic complex, meanwhile, was substantially added to, with buildings across Mint Walk and the 19-floor Taberner House to house the rapidly expanding corporation's employees. Croydon Council's offices were in Taberner House until September 2013. Ruskin House is the headquarters of Croydon's labour, trade union and cooperative movements and is itself a cooperative with shareholders from organisations across the three movements. In the 19th century, Croydon was a bustling commercial centre of London. It was said that, at the turn of the 20th century, approximately £10,000 was spent in Croydon's taverns and inns every week for the early labour movement. Then, it was natural to meet in the town's public houses. In this environment, however, the temperance movement was equally strong, and Georgina King Lewis, a keen member of the Croydon United Temperance Council, took it upon herself to establish a dry centre for the labour movement. The first Ruskin House was highly successful, and there has been two more since. The current house was officially opened in 1967 by the then Labour Prime Minister, Harold Wilson. Today, Ruskin House continues to serve as the headquarters of the trade union, labour and cooperative movements in Croydon, hosting a range of meetings and being the base for several labour movement groups. Office tenants include the headquarters of the Communist Party of Britain and Croydon Labour Party. Garrett Davies, the MP for Croydon Central, had offices in the building, until he was defeated by Andrew Pelling and is now the Labour representative standing for Swansea West in Wales. Bernard Wetherill House, home to Croydon Council from September 2013. Taberner House was built between 1964 and 1967, designed by architect H. Thornley, with Alan Holt and Hugh Lee as borough engineers. Although the council had needed extra space since the 1920s, it was only with the imminent creation of the London Borough of Croydon that action was taken. The building, being demolished in 2014, was in classic 1960s style, praised at the time, but subsequently much derided. It has its elegant upper slab block narrowing towards both ends, a formal device which has been compared to the famous Pirelli Tower in Milan. It was named after Ernest Taberner Obe, town clerk from 1937 to 1963 until September 2013. Taberner House housed most of the council's central employees and was the main location for the public to access information and services, particularly with respect to housing. In September 2013, council staff moved into Bernard Wetherill House in Fell Road, named after the former Speaker of the House and Member of Parliament for Croydon North East. Staff from the Met Police, NHS, Jobcentre Plus, Croydon Credit Union, Citizens Advice Bureau, as well as 75 services from the council all moved to the new building. Geography and climate. The borough is in the far south of London, with the M25 orbital motorway stretching to the south of it, between Croydon and Tandridge in the north and east of Croydon. The authority mainly borders the London Borough of Bromley, and in the northwest the boroughs of Lambeth and Southwark. The boroughs of Sutton and Merton are located directly to the west. It is at the head of the River Wandle, just to the north of a significant gap in the North Downs. It lies 10 miles 16. It was pedestrianized in 1989 to attract people back to the town center. Another shopping center called Park Place was due to open in 2012 but has since been scrapped. Townscape description. See also, list of districts in Croydon. North End Shopping Street after the pedestrianization of the road. The CR postcode area covers most of the south and center of the borough, while the SE and SW postcodes cover the northern parts, including Crystal Palace, Upper Norwood, South Norwood, Selhurst, Thornton Heath, Norbury and Pollards Hill districts. In the London borough of Croydon include Addington, a small village to the east of Croydon which until 2000 was poorly linked to the rest of the borough as it was without any railway or light rail stations with only a few patchy bus services to rely on. Addiscombe is a district just northeast of the centre of Croydon, and is popular with commuters to central London due to its close proximity to the busy East Croydon station. Ashburton, to the northeast of Croydon, is mostly home to residential houses and flats, being named after Ashburton House, one of the three big houses in the Addiscombe area. Broad Green is a small district, centered on a large green with many homes and local shops in West Croydon. Coombe is an area, just east of Croydon, which has barely been urbanized and has retained its collection of large houses fairly intact. Coolsden, southwest of central Croydon, which has retained a good mix of traditional high street shops as well as a large number of restaurants for its size. Croydon is the principal area of the borough. Crystal Palace is an area north of Croydon, which is shared with the London boroughs of Lambeth, Southwark, Lewisham and Bromley. Fairfield, just northeast of Croydon, holds the Fairfield Halls and the village of Forestdale, to the east of Croydon's main area, commenced work in the late 1960s and completed in the mid-70s to create a larger town on what was previously open ground. Hampsey Green is a place on the plateau of the North Downs, south of Croydon. Kenley, again south of the centre, lie within the London Green Belt and features a landscape dominated by green space. New Addington, to the east, is a large local council estate surrounded by open countryside and golf courses. Norbury, to the northwest, is a suburb with a large ethnic population. Norwood New Town is a part of the Norwood Triangle, to the north of Croydon. Monk's Orchard is a small district made up of large houses and open space in the northeast of the borough. Pollards Hill is a residential district with houses on roads, which are lined with pollarded lime trees, stretching to Norbury. Purley, to the south, is a main town whose name derives from Perlea, which means pear tree lee. Sanderstead, to the south, is a village mainly on high ground at the edge of suburban development in Greater London. Selhurst is a town, to the north of Croydon, which holds the nationally known school, the Brit School. Selsdon is a suburb which was developed during the inter-war period in the 1920s and 1930s, and is remarkable for its many Art Deco houses. To the southeast of Croydon Centre. Shirley, is to the east of Croydon, and holds Shirley Windmill. South Croydon, to the south of Croydon, is a locality which holds local landmarks such as the Swan and Sugarloaf Public House and Independent Whitgift School, part of the Whitgift Foundation. South Norwood, to the north, is in common with West Norwood and Upper Norwood, named after a contraction of Great North Wood, and has a population of around 14,590. Thornton Heath is a town, to the northwest of Croydon, which holds Croydon's principal hospital. Mayday. Upper Norwood is, north of Croydon, on a mainly elevated area of the borough. Wadden is a residential area, mainly based on the Purley Way retail area, to the west of the borough. Woodside is located to the northeast of the borough, with streets based on Woodside Green, a small-sized area of green land. And finally Whiteleaf is a town, right to the edge of Croydon, with some areas in the Surrey district of Tandridge. Croydon is a gateway to the south from central London, and therefore has a number of major roads running through it. Purley Way on the A23 road was built to bypass Croydon town centre, on which the A23 once did, is one of the busiest roads in the borough, and has been the site of several major retail developments, including one of only 18 IKEA stores in the country, built on the site of the former power station. It carries onto Brighton Road, which is the main route running towards the south from Croydon to Purley, and continues on the A23. The centre of Croydon is very congested, and the urban planning has since become out of date and quite inadequate, due to the expansion of Croydon's main shopping area and office blocks. Wellesley Road is a dual carriageway that cuts through the centre of the town, and makes it hard to interchange between the Civic Centre's two railway stations. Croydon Vision 2020 includes a plan for a more pedestrian-friendly replacement. It has also been named as one of the worst roads for cyclists in the area. Construction of the Croydon Underpass beneath the junction of George Street and Wellesley Road Park Lane during the early 60s started, with the main aim to prevent traffic congestion on Park Lane, situated above the underpass. The Croydon flyover on the other hand is situated near the underpass and next to Taberner House. It mainly leads traffic onto Duppas Hill, towards Purley Way, with the intention for easy links with Sutton and Kingston upon Thames. Further afield, the major junction on the flyover is for Old Town, which is also a large three-lane road. Topography and climate. Croydon climate chart explanation. JFM. AMJJASOND. 34. 5. OND. 6346. 19. 46. Croydon covers an area of 8,652. The nearest weather station is at Gatwick Airport. Architecture. Further information, architecture of Croydon and list of tallest buildings and structures in Croydon. The skyline of Croydon has significantly changed over the past 50 years. High-rise buildings, mainly office blocks, now dominate the skyline. The most notable of these buildings include Croydon Council's headquarters, Taberner House, which has been compared to the famous Pirelli Tower of Milan, and the Nestle Tower, the former UK headquarters of Nestle in recent years. The development of tall buildings, such as the approved Croydon Vocational Tower and Wellesley Square, has been encouraged in the London Plan, which will lead to the erection of new skyscrapers over the next few years as London goes through a high-rise boom. Number 1. Croydon, formerly the NLA Tower, Britain's 88th tallest tower, close to East Croydon Station, is an example of 1970s architecture. The tower was originally nicknamed the Threepenny Bit Building, as it resembles a stack of pre-decimalization threepence coins, which were 12-sided. It is now most commonly called the Octagon, being 8-sided. Lunar House is another high-rise building like other government office buildings on Wellesley Road, such as Apollo House. The name of the building was inspired by the U.S. Moon landings. In the Croydon suburb of New Addington, there is a public house, built during the same period, called the Man on the Moon. Lunar House houses the Home Office building for visas and immigration. Apollo House houses the Border Patrol Agency. A new generation of buildings are being considered by the council as part of Croydon Vision 2020, so that the borough doesn't lose its title of having the largest office space in the southeast, excluding central London projects such as Wellesley Square, which will be a mix of residential and retail with an eye-catching color design. And 100 George Street, a proposed modern office block, are incorporated in this vision. Notable events that have happened to Croydon's skyline include the Millennium Project to create the largest single urban lighting project ever. It was created for the buildings of Croydon to illuminate them for the third millennium. Not only did this project give new lighting to the buildings, but it provided an opportunity to project onto them images and words, mixing art and poetry with colored light, and also displaying public information after dark. Apart from increasing nighttime activity in Croydon and thereby reducing the fear of crime, it helped to promote the sustainable use of older buildings by displaying them in a more positive way. Demography. Population. Year. Pop. Plus or minus percent. 1901 141,918. 1951 299,271 64%. 1961 316,084 56%. 1971 333,942 56%. 1981 316,296 -53%. 1991 319,218 09%. 2001 330,688 36%. 2011 363,499% 2013 372,759 26%. Source: A Vision of Britain Through Time. According to the 2001 census, Croydon has a population of around 269,100 in 2005. This was recorded to have risen up to 342,700, making Croydon the ninth most populous local authority in England out of 354 boroughs. 159,111 were males, with 171,476 females in 2001. The number of people per hectare in Croydon was 3,821, in London 4,562, and in England 377. The mean age of the residents of Croydon was 3,375 and 233,748 out of 330,587 residents described their health as good. White is the majority Swahili ethnicity with over 72%, compared to 92% in England as a whole. Black was the second largest ethnicity, over 13%, 113% is South Asian. The most common householder type were owner-occupied, with only a small percentage rented. Many new housing schemes and developments are currently taking place in Croydon, such as the Exchange and Bridge House, IYLO, Wellesley Square, now known as Saffron Square, and Altitude 25 in 2006. The Metropolitan Police recorded a 10% fall in the number of crimes committed in Croydon, better than the rate which crime in London as a whole is falling. Croydon has had the highest fall in the number of cases of violence against the person in South London, and is one of the top 10 safest local authorities in London, according to Your Croydon, a local community magazine. This is due to a stronger partnership struck between Croydon Council and the police in 2007. Overall crime figures across the borough saw a decrease of 5%, with the number of incidents decreasing from 32,506 in 2006 to 30,862 in 2007. However, in the year ending April 2012, the Metropolitan Police recorded the highest rates for murder and rape throughout London in Croydon, accounting for almost 10% of all murders, and 7% of all rapes. Croydon has 5 police stations. Croydon Police Station is on Park Lane in the centre of the town near the Fairfield Halls. South Norwood Police Station is a newly refurbished building just off the High Street. Norbury Police Station is on London Road. Kenley Station is on Godstone Road. And New Addington Police Station is on Addington Village Road. Population change. The table shows details on the population change since 1901, including the percentage change since the last available census data. Although the London Borough of Croydon has existed as a London Borough since 1963, figures have been generated by combining data from the towns.